Cardinals take on the number one team in the Big East Conference, the sixth ranked Georgetown Hoyas. Welcome to ESPN Saturday Night Primetime, presented by DirecTV, a part of Rivalry Week, presented by Cisco. This game has national significance, and of course, it has a ton of significance within the Big East Conference. Here's the top eight of the 16 team Big East, a win for Louisville tonight, and look how tight things get at the top of the standings. But a win for Georgetown, they open up a little space between themselves and everybody else. Hi, everybody, and welcome to Louisville. Dan Schulman, glad to be... Well, let me rephrase that. Glad to be back with Dick Vitale. You sounded great on Wednesday. It's great to have you back, and what a game we've got going here tonight.
Well, two of the Goliaths, as you said, in the Big East. I think right now the Pac-10 and the Big East are the two toughest conferences in America. Both these teams really mirror each other. Louisville, for example, and Georgetown average about 70 points a game. They both field goal percentage-wise. Georgetown, number one in the nation, 35.5. Louisville, 37%. They both turn the ball over 12 times. It's a big game, but it's more of a must game for Louisville on their home floor.
They're as healthy as they've been all season. They're playing some really good basketball right now. Time for our Star Watch, brought to you by Chevron.
Well, we talk about Star Watch, you got to start in the middle. Boy, Hibbert was brilliant here last year when they beat Louisville at 20 points, 11 rebounds. Don't measure him by his stats. He's one of the reasons why they lead the nation in field goal position defense. Padgett, since he came back in November, has been such a plus. Experience, passes the ball really well, and he can make plays.
And time now to check our starting lineups. We begin with the visiting Georgetown Hoyas. A three-guard backcourt, including Jonathan Wallace, a senior who's made more threes than anybody in Georgetown history. Jesse Sabbath, the freshman, Austin Freeman alongside him. Roy Hibbert is joined by a very talented player, sophomore DeJuan Summers up front. For the Cardinals in the backcourt, Edgar Sosa and Jerry Smith, both capable of lighting it up. And up front, a lot of depth, a lot of talent, including Terrence Williams, a guy who has had two triple-doubles this year for Louisville. But a healthy David Padgett has taken this team to a new level. With more on that, let's go to Aaron Andrews.
Well, Dan, Louisville head coach Rick Pitino says we are now a better basketball team because David Padgett is back with us. What a great story with David Padgett. Goes down with a broken kneecap in mid-November after 7 weeks of intense rehab. He joined his team back on the basketball court. Now, Rick Pitino has said this week that he is about 100% healthy, even though he admits he shouldn't even be playing right now. There are no restrictions on him. He can change directions on the floor, and he is jumping fluidly, which is great news tonight with that big matchup. I get no kiss over here, Dick Vitale. Dan Schulman gets the kiss.
Dick, you owe EA a kiss.
I tell you one thing, I'd rather give her a kiss than you.
I'm not arguing.
Well, I did one before the game. She gave me a big kiss, and my wife was right there.
Well, you saw Rick Pitino in the white suit. It is a whiteout night here at Freedom Hall, and Rick Pitino is going right along with the theme. This is a big one, folks. Mike Pitts, Brian O'Connell, John Higgins, two of the top teams in the Big East. At the beginning of the season, the 16 coaches were asked who's going to win the league. Eight pick Georgetown, eight pick Louisville. Not even the hops of Terrence Williams could get up high enough for that. JT3, John Thompson the third, and what an outstanding run he has had in 4 years at the helm of the Hoyas, getting better and better every year.
I tell you one thing, he's done a great job with them, learning offensive efficiency and also how to defend so well. They don't allow you to get layups on the inside. Seen a little zone right now by Louisville. Gonna make him shoot the perimeter shot.
Jonathan Wallace will. He'll miss the three, and the ball knocked out of the hands of Hibbert to the Cardinals.
They need some scoring out of Wallace. Last two games, he totaled 5 points. Yep. He has to put some points on the board here tonight.
Hibbert's size affecting that Padgett pass. Louisville turns it over. Driving and banking it too strong off the glass is Jesse Sapp. They go flying into the Louisville bench, and it's Cardinal ball.
Tell you one thing, their backcourt is so experienced. Wallace and Sapp don't get enough publicity, notoriety. They've won 24 of their last 26 games in conference play. I mean, that's unbelievable. That's not a cupcake conference.
No, inarguably the best conference in the country. They won the Big East regular season a year ago. They won the Big East tournament a year ago. They went to the Final Four, lost to Ohio State. And even with the loss of Jeff Green, player of the year in the conference last year, everybody else is back a year older and wiser. And this team may be even a little bit better.
Well, they got a little bit more depth this year. Got some good freshmen Freeman certainly a guy that's produced. And Ewing's giving them great play coming off the bench. They changed their starting lineup. They put Freeman in the lineup and bringing Ewing off the bench.
Louisville is going to show Georgetown a lot of different looks tonight, both full court. Sometimes they'll press two or three different presses and also in the half court D.
Yeah, multiple defenses. Natter and a man-to-man came out of the zone, trying to get them out of any rhythm offensively.
Georgetown very comfortable running the clock down to get a good look. And Hibbert slams it home.
You know, it's amazing about Hibbert. You can't measure him just by those numbers. 13 a game, 7 rebounds a game. His presence in that 3-second area is the reason they lead the nation in field goal percentage defensively. And
John Thompson III says that his understanding of what he can do on the court is way ahead of where it was a year ago. David Padgett goes right around him and scoops it up and in.
I tell you, what a story. Who would have ever believed that he would have been back on New Year's after fracturing his knee? Cap.
Not to mention a couple of years ago, remember he had serious surgery on both knees. Two or three times we have heard that his career could be over.
We've seen three different defenses already. You saw the 2-2-1 right there. Now they flatten out into a 2-3 zone.
What an atmosphere here tonight. Rick Pitino saying this is the toughest ticket in this building in the last 8 years. Summers from the elbow knocks down the jumper.
He has really been able to make shots. There is Mr. Pitino. I tell you, he's all GQ tonight,
looks
baby.
Good, huh?
I know his wife Joanne must be proud of that suit he's wearing.
Right in theme with the whiteout here in a Freedom Hall. 4-2 Georgetown early. Through the hands of Williams, stolen away by Wallace. Williams fouls him.
Tell you one thing they're doing a little bit more this year, Georgetown. The Hoyas are getting out in transition more often. Take a look at Hibbert going without the basketball. A little cut, part of the Princeton offense, and there's the jam. Then we go on the other end. The star, Mr. Padgett, says, I'm going to go right at the basket. Nice reverse layup. Transfer came out of the University of Kansas where they got a great team. I think Bill Self's club athletically is going to be such a monster come tournament time.
Got a battle on their hands with a Baylor tonight, the Jayhawks do.
Baylor really improved this year.
Summers feeling it early. Misses the baseline jumper and ripping it down is Williams, who's a threat for a triple-double on any given night.
He can pass the ball. He really gives him another point guard out on the wing.
Imagine another guy can't measure by his stats. Slips the
nice
screen
play.
And dunks it home.
Simple screen and roll. Execution. Part of the formula of Rick Pitino, a terrific teacher. A future Hall of Famer with his 500th game this year. There's a little release off the screen. Go right to the goal. I tell you one thing, Padgett has great understanding and savvy how to play the game. Now watch this right here. Freeze the release and go to the basket. There it is for the jam. Catches the defense staring at the basketball.
Foul on DeJuan Summers. Padgett missed 10 games, 7 weeks after the broken kneecap, but is feeling better and better, and whether it's his communication on defense, setting screens, slipping screens, passing the ball, he does so many things for Louisville.
I don't think he shoots enough. He's 6-for-9 in the last 2 games. He's got to get more opportunities.
Wallace driving on Sosa. Kicks it back out. Zappa, deep three. And it's out of bounds. Back to the Cardinals. Let's get more on Rick Pitino and his look tonight. Here's our fashion consultant, Aaron Andrews.
Well, this wardrobe report, sponsored by Kidding, of course. Hey, the 411 on the white suit, I was talking to some of the players about it. He said, Coach Pitino did not have this outfit on in the locker room. The team ran out onto the floor, the coaching staff, and then Coach Pitino came out on his own. The players and the crowd went nuts when they saw him, Dan, just like they did after that basket right there.
And I can imagine why. They're loving the action on the floor. This time it was Padgett with the feed and Earl Clark with the dunk.
I tell you, Earl Clark gets the dunk from out of New Jersey. Very rarely do you see teams score on the inside against the Hoyas. Hoyas are going to have an absolute tough, tough night here tonight.
Sosa stepped out of bounds. That last basket doesn't count. But Louisville on whiteout night here in Freedom Hall is white hot early with a 3-point lead on the Hoyas.
I tell you, the Hoyas are really going to have to regroup early and not give them so much momentum.
Like Zoinks, it's the cable guy.
Well, now that DirecTV has way more HD channels than cable, he had to try to stop everyone from switching to DirecTV.
Get over 90 of the best channels in HD now on DirecTV.
I got something for you. Happy Valentine's Day, sweet pea. Shiny, isn't it?
You love how it looks. You think I'm the perfect man.
You are very happy with me right now. I'm happy when you're happy.
Available at the jewelry store, inside JCPenney.
Get ready for an explosion of indescribably crunchy, cheesy flavor. It's the new Crunchy Cheesy Crust Pizza from Pizza Hut. Cheese baked right onto the crust for a crunch that unlocks a flavor shockwave. Try one now for just $11.99. And now get two free bottles of new G2 from Gatorade when you buy a Crunchy Cheesy Crust Pizza. Get more, not less. Pizza Hut. Order online.
That guy already knows what this is. Because you're not that guy, there's Helzberg Diamonds, where you could learn this is a graduated diamond journey pendant with 7-round brilliant cut diamonds, now specially priced at just $99.99. Helzberg Diamonds, helping regular guys since 1915.
ABC, your NBA Sunday destination. ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is presented by DirecTV. Must-have equipment for any sports fan. And in part by JCPenney. Every day matters.
And a beautiful shot of downtown Louisville. This ESPN telecast available in high definition on ESPN HD, presented by Olivia. Dan Shulman, Vic Vitale, Aaron Andrews, the Gameday gang, all here at sold out Freedom Hall for the Cardinals and the Hoyas. This Louisville team may not be ranked, but this is one of those teams, one of those games you say, forget about the rankings. Louisville has had their problems with injuries. They had some suspensions early. They're a whole unit now, Dick, really for the first time all year. This is a very dangerous team.
Well, anytime you can come off the bench with guys like Sosa and Character and Clark, you know you're a deep club. McGee, they got a deep basketball team, and they're healthy, as you said earlier, Dan, for the first time.
Looking for Hibbert in the middle of that 2-3 zone. Hibbert, a good passing big man as well.
He's a terrific passer. Rick Pitino was singing his praises about his passing ability in the post.
Georgetown is 19-2 overall, 9-1 in the Big East. They've had some close calls recently. Remember the Hibbert three that beat UConn in the final few seconds? A one-point win over West Virginia on a controversial block by Ewing. Again, a two-man game. The pick and roll working beautifully so far tonight for Louisville as we check our Sonic rivalry recap. These two schools have only met six times. Georgetown has won the last four. Louisville last won over 50 years ago. Georgetown's got a win over Louisville in the national semifinal back in 1982.
I'll tell you one thing, Dan, they're doing a great job executing in their half-court game. Louisville getting a lot of ball movement, player movement, setting screens.
And with Padgett back and Palacios back, Rick Pitino now has four big men that he can rotate in and out of the game with Padgett, Clark, Character and Palacios.
I'll tell you something else. Both clubs have a similarity in a way to Florida. They got five guys averaging double figures, and their leading scorer is only about 13 points a game. That was really part of Billy Donovan's system with Florida. In fact, last year Green led them in scoring, and you looked at that club, they had three guys drafted in the top nine, but they were so unselfish, and that's what these clubs are about. Being unselfish. Share the ball, take the high percentage shot.
The Cardinals on a 7-0 run right now. Forget about that. Is Austin Freeman, the freshman out of Mitchellville, Maryland, hits it.
Well, he went to DeMatha. He's one of the first. He is the first player to be recruited by Georgetown out of DeMatha. And he's going to be a really outstanding player.
Yes, John Thompson III. What's his best position? And coach said he's just a player. He can play anywhere.
I love those kind of guys. They're versatile, multidimensional.
Padgett and Williams, probably the two best passers on the team. And, of course, as you say that, Williams throws it away. But those two guys will connect often tonight. Hey, Monday, Rivalry Week presented by Cisco concludes with a doubleheader here on ESPN. These Hoyas will take on the Villanova Wildcats. You've got a win over Seton Hall today. And then at 9 Eastern, Kansas taking on Texas. Texas needed overtime today to pick up a win at Iowa State.
Tell you one thing, when you look at Texas with that backcourt, they have a chance to win every time on our floor. DJ Augustine and Abrams, they really outstanding for Rick Barnes' club, who loses Durant to the NBA.
Great doubleheader of action Monday night here on ESPN. Jeremiah Rivers, son of Doc, into the game for the Hoyas, and it's Rivers penetrating, and he gets fouled.
Tell you, Jeremiah does a great job defensively, gives him some great minutes. But you know what? He's not the star of the family. Now, Doc was terrific as a player, but there, yes, sir, his sister Callie, she was the rookie of the year, the diaper dandy in volleyball down in Gainesville.
Well, and he's got a younger brother down in Orlando where they live who's supposed to be a heck of a player, a basketball player. I think he's a high school junior. And Doc was going to come down to this game tonight, but they've got a day game tomorrow. Had this been a day game, he was going to come down and see it.
Well, with all his cash, he should jump in a private plane. He should have been here and flown back.
He's got come the Spurs on, tomorrow. Turnaround jumper by Roy Hibbert.
I tell you one thing about Hibbert. Doesn't take a lot of shots, but he maximizes each shot and utilizes getting good shots and good positioning.
The other member of Georgetown's second generation of gang is into the game now. Patrick Ewing Jr. gives them energy and rebounding off the bench.
He's really playing well. His father would have been so proud of that block shot against West Virginia. I thought it was a good block from my angle. Bobby Huggins did it, but it was a terrific play by Ewing.
Battle of the big guys, Dick.
There's Hibbert getting the ball in deep. Nice little turn, shoots the jumper, beats Connecticut, as you said earlier, with a three. He's made two threes this year.
Palacios in, Andre McGee in, Preston Knowles in as well. And these two guards here, 33 McGee,
they get after
and two Knowles. That's right. Rick Pitino says their defense goes up a notch when these guys come into the game.
Yeah, he really would like to see better defense out of Sosa, who's really a better offensive player.
Knowles is a guy with a great passion and desire, not playing all that much as a freshman. Look at the rainbow three that won't drop for Wallace, but an offensive rebound for the Hoyas.
I tell you right now, the way the game plan is, that 2-3 zone is going to make them really make some perimeter shots.
It's going to stay at this end as Terrence Williams quickly checks back in.
John Thompson flashing those numbers, plays. Played at Princeton, Petey Correll. Learned so much from Petey and certainly from his dad.
Still keeps in touch with Coach Correll.
He said he talks to him regularly, and why not?
Boy, Summers is a talent. A 6'8", 240-pound sophomore who can run and jump and shoot and do just about everything.
Well, you got to make that three. You got to really be able to make that three against that kind of zone to spread it and open it up.
8-0 run for the Hoyas. They're back on top.
Do you think that we, as the Coke brand, would have a case against the Coke Zero brand? For taste infringement.
What's your specialty?
I am in real estate law.
Perfect.
Perfect. Right.
Let's say
this is a property.
An architectural, it's made a landmark. Next door, somebody buys the lot. They build an eerily similar house.
What can we do there?
Let's put on the lawyer pants and walk down that path. Da, 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 da.
Well, of course, the Hoya program reached its greatest heights in the mid-80s, won the national championship in 1984 under Big John, John Thompson Jr., JT3 now in his fourth year as head coach of the Hoyas, and they've gotten stronger and stronger every year. First year, Dick, they go to the NIT, win 19 games, then a Sweet 16, then a Final Four, and who knows where they'll wind up this year.
Well, you know, that 1984 team defensively was so strong, dominant, anchored by Patrick Ewing, who's eligible this year for the Hall of Fame, and is a lock.
Gotta be.
He and Olajuwon are locks.
Padgett, the jump hook over Hibbert, won't go down. Tough to get a shot over the 7-foot, 2-inch Roy Hibbert.
You don't get many offensive rebounds against Georgetown. Not with that size. See, he's looking to make passes. He really is such an outstanding passer with that great size. He has good vision.
Here's the quarterback, though, Jonathan Wallace out of Alabama. Was a walk-on at the beginning of his career as Hibbert misses, but Wallace has started every single game in his four-year career.
And he's going to be a lawyer. He's already been admitted to Georgetown Law School.
It's a block. And Terrence Williams will be going to the line when we come back from this timeout. The Hoyas and the Cardinals, two of the beasts of the Big East. A three-point lead, Georgetown early.
All right, international shipping. Well, your products are on a plane, ready to go to your customers in Europe to arrive on Friday. But Italy wants it there by noon, Paris early morning, and London late afternoon.
Well, if you had a UPS logo,
now when your customers ask, you can say, si, oui, and yes. It's not international shipping. It's international shipping with UPS. And you even got a little tailwind.
Boost Mobile, let's go. If I ain't living, I don't know who is. In this city, got cars and a place to live.
I'm off and I don't care about cost. Last name Dupree, first name the boss.
I came from the bottom, now I'm in the tipping. Made my mark in it so they never forget me. Mama always said, baby boy, you gon' make it. They wouldn't give it to me, so I had to take it. What's up?
I'm that dude that got what you need. Eyes on the prize, picking up speed. It's out there, I'm gon' get it.
Hey, living out my dream, so you know the boy with it.
Where you at?
Legally, we cannot say Toughbook laptops will withstand fire, take a bullet, or secure classified material. We can't say they save lives, build cities, tune cars that finish first, or that we're the king of all laptops. Our lawyers are just doing their jobs. Panasonic Toughbook laptops, the rugged original, with Intel Centrino Duo processor technology. Visit Panasonic.com/Toughbook for more. Panasonic, ideas for life.
IBM presents the 25 greatest players ever. Number 21, Tim Duncan. No other player has won more games in a four-year span at Wake Forest University. Tim Duncan averaged nearly 17 points and 12 rebounds for his career. The two-time All-American also ranks third all-time in NCAA for blocks. IBM, getting it done.
Whatever happened to him?
I'll take it in the pros?
You talk about a guy that was special. Tim Duncan, Dave Odom, they were terrific, absolutely.
And we will count down the top 25 every night of college basketball, and we'll announce the number one player of all time during the Carolina-Duke game on March the 8th. Here's a look at 25 wow. through 21. Can you imagine there are 20 25. Better college players than these guys?
Unbelievable.
I mean, Calvin, Austin Carr at 22?
Some people would say Calvin Murphy, pound for pound, inch for inch. I mean, he was unstoppable at Niagara. Unstoppable. I'll tell you one thing, South Carolina's job's open. If I was down there, I would make a call. I would absolutely make a call down at Texas Tech, and I'd say, Mr. Robert Montgomery Knight, got 10 years left. Can you imagine hooking up Knight with Spurrier? Steve Spurrier and Robert Montgomery Knight together? Wow. I think it'd be phenomenal.
Williams knocks down the first free throw. Here's a look at what Louisville's season has been like so far. Rick Pitino with the injuries to Padgett and Palacio. They struggled early, shorthanded, lost some games out of conference. They're hot now. Very good defense. And Terrence Williams not really looking for his offense as much as he has in the past. Very content to be a distributor. He's happy to find Padgett, Smith, whoever's going to knock down shots. And like we said, they get after you defensively.
I tell you, the 700th game that he's coaching right now in college. Can you imagine? He's got 511 wins. Had he not gone to the pros, how many wins he would have? Unbelievable.
This is a Louisville team that has played and soundly beaten a Marquette team twice already this season.
No, they've only turned the ball over the last three games 32 times. They've already turned it over five times tonight.
That's the first turnover by Georgetown. Tough shot by Andre McGee. And Rick Pitino's main message for his team the last couple of weeks is, guys, take good shots. Don't take contested shots.
Yeah, he doesn't want challenge shots. He thought in that game they lost to Connecticut, they took 33 threes. He said about 20 of them were challenged. Yeah. He said, you got to take open shots.
Vernon Macklin, number one, is checked in now for Georgetown. He was a McDonald's All-American coming out of high school. Has not quite lived up to that billing playing off the bench for the Hoyas.
But he is getting better and better. They see progress in his game right now. Getting familiar to the college game has been a big adjustment for him.
Sapp uses the screen, misses the three. Character bobbles the rebound. Ewing comes up with it.
Ewing started his career down in Indiana with the Hoosiers. He had that scintillating last-second win over Illinois in double overtime.
Hey, we'll see that next week when they take on Michigan State in Bloomington. And a big Monday presented by Bud Light on ESPN2 at 7 Eastern has women's college basketball with a rematch of last year's championship game. Rutgers taking on Tennessee. The big story here, will Candace Parker play? Will she be back from the injury? Epiphany Prince, by the way, had 33.
Against Connecticut, against she was UConn. Absolutely brilliant that game. Vivian Stringer and Pat Summitt. Pat Summitt, we're honoring on our big date on May 16th with Robert Montgomery Knight for the V Foundation.
There's the injury to Candace Parker, a hyperextended knee, questionable for that game on Monday.
She'll play. Flat out, she'll play. Just reading her quotes. She said, I will be there on Monday. I read a quote. There's that zone right now, that 2-3, really slowing the tempo of the game down. The tempo's become a real half-court-oriented basketball. basketball game.
Ewing might have gotten away with a walk. He's on the glass again, but Williams comes down with it and is fouled. It'll be Rivers, I believe, getting called for Georgetown.
You know the one thing that's happened in Terrence Williams' game? I think his first 2 years, he wanted to prove to all the naysayers who said he couldn't make a perimeter shot, and he tried to take so many bad shots. Now he's playing within himself. He's doing the things he's really outstanding at. Pass the ball, rebound, score when the opportunity is there.
In Louisville history, there have been four triple-doubles.
He's got two of them.
He's got two of them this season. Another Louisville turnover. Edgar Sosa returns.
I tell you, take the six losses that Louisville had. Terrence Williams, I looked it up, has really struggled. He was 21 for 69. I mean, that's just 30% in those six losses, just like shooting the three. In those losses, Louisville has shot so poorly from the three, 41 for 153. That's 26%. I mean, even a dummy like me could figure that's less than 30%.
Big game for Louisville, a win here, and they move closer to possibly finishing in the top four in the Big East to get that first round bye in the tournament. If Georgetown wins, they'll have a game and a half lead over the second place team in the Big East, Notre Dame, which beat Marquette today. Another big game for Luke Herangode, who just might be the player of the year in the Big East.
He was at my choice. I mean, there's a kid that did come in, he'll be highly acclaimed. He's been sensational all year. And what about Mike Bray's coach of the year again? I mean, who would have thought after losing Carter and Falls they'd be where they are?
Hey, I'd like to throw Mick Cronin's name out there, too, at Cincinnati. They're 6-5 in the league. Whoever would have thought that?
I got another name for you.
Right.
Jim Calhoun, the way he's got that club playing, where they regrouped after he's got the suspension to show discipline.
Palacios misses the jumper. By the way, if you don't think Herangode should be player of the year in the Big East, the president of his fan club is here. Hubert Davis is in the building tonight. And listen, at halftime, he'll talk up Luke Herangode. Macklin cannot save it. It'll be Louisville ball.
I'll tell you one thing about John Thompson III and his team. I really was so impressed talking to all the kids before the game. What classy kids they are. Really, when you think about Wallace, Sapp, I mean, you saw him come over here. Welcome back, Mr. Vital. I mean, just really, really nice kids.
Yeah, reflecting the character of their coach, who has just called a 30-second timeout.
You know, it's really interesting. You think of the big people, Hibbert. You think of the pass guys, Mourning, and certainly Mutombo and Ewing. All four, just phenomenal, classy guys.
And ever since Roy Hibbert was a little kid, he grew up in Maryland, all he wanted to do was play at Georgetown.
Take a look right now, some of the big men on campus. There's Mr. Beasley, who'd be my choice right now as National Player of the Year. Hibbert's certainly a major factor with Georgetown. Hansbrough right behind, closing the gap on Beasley. Kevin Love coming on really strong, trying to chase those two. Brook Lopez, he's become so solid since academically being eligible. And what about this guy's stock? It just keeps going up and up and up. And if he stays on college for another year, he will be the most dominant player on the collegiate scene. I think I read a quote by Jim Calhoun about that as well.
He had 24 today in the win over Georgia Tech. Connecticut stepping out of conference and got a nice win from a stubborn Yellow Jacket team today.
But the Yellow Jackets have really been playing well lately.
Rivers turns it over. Terrence Williams off to the races.
And John Sidney up, up, and away. As Louisville with that good defense causing a turnover. And then he rotates right into the man pressure.
Now Rick Pitino says their offense helps create good defense. The more they score, the more they can set up their press.
Yeah, making shots is something that they have not really done well.
Ewing with a nice move, dig right into the chest of David Padgett.
Tell you, Ewing's really been exceptional off the bench. He's a guy going to get consideration as one of the premier six men in the game, even though I'd give that edge to either Green at North Carolina or Shire at Duke.
You know, Ewing started the first 10 games, then they moved him to the bench, and he said, you know what, I prefer coming off the bench. His minutes are the same. He's just more comfortable on the second unit. Padgett is called for the offensive foul.
They get him with the swim stroke on the inside as the intense Pitino, Hall of Famer, teacher, motivator. He's an author. Look at him inside. Now, right now, they're going to get him right here with the swing. See, that's where they nailed him.
Let's go get him. Good luck.
The NASCAR Nationwide Series at Daytona. Coverage begins next Saturday with the Camping World 300 on ESPN2.
What do you call that again?
An avatar. A digital simulation of me in a virtual world.
What's it do?
business. It's innovation. It's all the rage. I have my own island.
Making any money on your island?
Virtual money or actual money?
The point of innovation is to make actual money.
My avatar doesn't know how to do that.
We're late.
Going somewhere with your fiesta platters?
A meeting?
The meeting can wait. Fiesta platters are truly a meal, and meals are meant to be enjoyed.
What's going on?
Hola.
Taco Bell's new
Fiesta platters!
Grilled steak or chicken soft tacos, rice and beans, chips, and chunky salsa. Get it fast, enjoy it slow.
Hola.
You won't see them prancing in the end zone or preening for the cameras. Nope. They're too busy defending their turf and sometimes wearing it. All in the name of protecting the quarterback, the offensive lineman, guys like Nasty, Stink, Jumbo, and Jimbo. State Farm salutes the centers, the guards, the tackles, because we know there's no substitute for great protection.
Ryan Burr with your SportsCenter 30 at 30 update. UConn, number 19 in the land, riding a six-game winning streak. Make it seven, hosting Georgia Tech. Hashim Tabeet, 24 points, 15 rebounds, and six block shots. The Washington Redskins have hired Jim Zorn as their next head coach, a surprise ending to a month-long search. SportsCenter, 11 p.m., ESPN News always on. Dan and Dick, back to you in the Ville.
Hey, what happened to Jim Fossil? He's going to be so disappointed. Zorn came out of nowhere for that job. Spagnuolo said, no, I'm staying with the Giants, baby. $2 million a year to be an assistant. That's less than what you're making, though. I'm looking at your cap. You worked NBA last night.
Hey, it sounds like you spent the last 6 weeks or so watching a lot of ESPN.
Nice cut.
Staying up on everything. And there's the backdoor feed that Georgetown runs. It's not the full-fledged Princeton offense, but obviously elements of that with where John Thompson came from.
I love teams that really move without the ball, executing their five-on-five game, which is going to be a must here to win tonight. Both these clubs get back in defensive transition. They pride themselves defensively. That's why teams shoot less than 38% against both these clubs.
Double team on Padgett, and it's off Ewing.
Oh, no hands.
You had it. Bad
no
hands, Dickie.
I had that, baby. A turnover.
I came over the back on you.
I wanted that, baby. I wanted to make that catch.
No shot. No hands. No hand. And
no
your
hands.
Lateral quicks are
no
lacking
speed.
A little bit, too.
No speed. I used to defend you, baby.
Yeah.
I deny him the ball, Timmy, too. Number one cameraman in the business, they tell me. We got a lot of great
cameramen.
They got
to tell you.
Timmy does a great job.
Smith, nice feed. Padgett.
Padgett really doing well on the inside. Think about it. He broke his kneecap on November 18th. Was back playing on January 1st. Had 13 points, played 27 minutes. Shocked everyone. A little running jump right there.
Well, one of the best things said by a college basketball player this year is Padgett knocks it away. He told the doctors, I don't care about anything beyond this year. I just want to finish my senior season playing for Louisville.
Talk about a kid that really is earning his scholarship. Guts. You talk about courage.
Tom Crane said he's one of the best facilitators in college basketball. How much better they are both ways when Padgett is on the floor. For more, back to EA.
I don't think we can say it enough. Amazing 6 weeks of rehab to get back from a broken kneecap. He basically said, I'll do whatever I need to do to get back. And the athletic training staff here at Louisville told me he did just that. And this is what is happening. He is sitting in the training room after practices and games with literally 7-pound ice bags on that right kneecap. I was told his pain tolerance is incredible, and it's a great example for other players on this Louisville team. Coach Pitino telling me, if you got a cold, if you got a bruise, I don't want to hear about it, because David Padgett came back from a broken kneecap.
The heart and soul of this team. Ewing misses the jumper, but the long rebound right back to him.
Hey, nice play by Ewing with that offensive rebound. Steps right in the gap. His father was such a dominant defensive player. But it intimidated when he arrived on a campus. Played for Mike Jarvis in high school on Cambridge, Massachusetts.
Ewing called for the foul. Character back in for Padgett. Haven't seen a whole lot of character tonight. A guy who's been really up and down this season and has had a well-documented battle with a number of
off-court issues in his 2 years at Louisville. There's what Padgett has done. He has been the major force for the Cardinals right now. Let's see how character matches up with the big Hoya front line.
I tell you, if there's any doubt they're playing well, they would have been at Bradley Center and beat Marquette by 14, and that was Marquette's first loss at home. Right now, the top four, without a doubt, are Georgetown, Notre Dame, Connecticut, and Louisville in conference play.
No Hibbert in the game right now. Zone for Georgetown, and Louisville turns it over. That's been a big problem for them. 10 already in this game.
You know, Georgetown trying to win back-to-back Big East titles. Won it last year, won the tournament, beating Pittsburgh in the final.
Backdoor feed again. Freeman looking for space underneath.
If he made that, he gets 5 points. He stayed with it, though.
That's a pretty tough one there.
He's got great upper body strength. He's a very strong player physically, and as John Thompson III told us, he can play almost anywhere.
Their other freshman, Chris Wright, is out with a foot injury, out indefinitely, may not play again this season, but Freeman has become a factor as Macklin fouls character.
You know, Wright would have been in that rotation. My word that I've received, he's done for the season. There he is right now. Now look at the angle. Has no chance for that, but stays with it. And now he squares his body, kisses it on the glass.
He's strong. Georgetown by 8 over Louisville.
They're on a little run right now, 18 yep. to 5. Louisville's got to make some threes. Georgetown really challenging the perimeter. Give them no looks on the three-point line.
Sosa goes around Summers, and there's the help on the block by Macklin.
They just take such pride defensively. 35% field goal percentage defensively. Uno number one in America. You know, Dan, think about it. If you're holding teams in the mid-30s, you got a chance to win every night on the floor.
Yep. They're a well-coached, smart, disciplined team with a lot of experience. 8 of their top 9 back from last year. Good hustle by Smith. Louisville takes over.
Smith's capable of hitting a three. Georgetown really matching up well. Guarding in the line. Not going to give them looks from the three. I tell you, John Thompson Jr., you talk about a guy that taught defense and intensity. His Georgetown teams always played such scrappy, tough defense, and his son doing the same.
Sosa with a tough leaner in the lane draws the foul.
You know, Sosa had 31 against Texas A&M, second round game. And since that, they think that game might have hurt him.
Couldn't get it up and over. Macklin, that big Hoya front line, is making its presence felt.
The intensity of rivalry week boils over on its last night.
Look at the emotion. How badly do they want it?
One of the most bitter Big East rivalries of old is renewed as Villanova clashes with Georgetown Monday at 7. Then, these rivals meet only once a year for the biggest game in the Big 12, Kansas versus Texas at 9. Rivalry Week presented by Cisco on ESPN.
You hear car, and what comes to mind? Okay, that's not car. And it's not 2 tons of metal, glass, and rubber. Car is why a kid picks up a crayon and why toy companies make these out of one of these. Car is why we'll stop for a chase scene or go just to go. Because unlike other vehicles, car is all about you. And it's what makes a Pontiac, like the Solstice GXP.
Happy Valentine's Day.
It's gorgeous.
This Valentine's Day, give her the Leo Diamond from Kay Jewelers. The first diamond ever to be independently certified for its superior brilliance. Handcrafted by the master diamond artisans at Leo Schachter and hand-selected to match beautifully by Kay Jewelers.
Charlie!
Happy Valentine's Day, Mandy.
Thank you.
Every kiss begins with K.
So I asked my dad where he wanted to go for his 60th birthday. Norway, he said, the land of our ancestors. We drank a pint at Ibsen's favorite pub. We sampled the local fare. We got new sweaters.
I feel like yodeling.
It was the trip of a lifetime, Dad said, until we went to the Hall of Records and discovered we were actually Swedish.
2 tickets to Stockholm, please.
Whatever your story is, your Citi card can help you ride it. Citi, let's get it done.
Back here at Freedom Hall, better than 19,000 people here. A sellout for Louisville and Georgetown, part of Rivalry Week presented by Cisco. Coming up on the UPS Halftime Report, there are the guys, Reese and Hubert and Digger and Jay, getting ready to bring you an action-packed halftime report as the Vols steal a win today. Texas taken to overtime by Iowa State, and Duke and Boston College in a spirited physical affair down in Cameron. Digger going with the yellow look tonight. The yellow shirt, tie, and highlighter. Good to be back amongst the crowd, the kids, the players, all that?
Absolutely, and there's no doubt about it, acting 12. But you know, tonight the key, I said in game day, Louisville to win has to make the three. Well, let me tell you, Georgetown's game plan was to shut off the three-point line. Well, have they shut it off? Louisville has not attempted a three yet today, number one, and they average 15 threes attempted per game. So I think the three-point shot has become big in a reverse fashion that Louisville has not been able to get any looks. And you got to credit John Thompson III's kids and his coaching staff for really doing a great job attacking the three-point line.
It's going to be over to Louisville here. Dick, 15, actually the fewest they've taken. They average 23 attempts a game from beyond the arc.
That's
the
23?
Most in the conference. 23.
Well, 15 was the less.
15's the fewest they've taken, and they haven't even attempted one here tonight.
So I got a turnover. I got a turnover on that.
That's
one.
All right.
I said 15.
That's all right. I don't have the quick hook. I don't have the quick hook. You're staying.
My one eye. See, caught the 15, but I didn't catch the 23.
That's all right. We'll let you play through it. Character inside, going right at Hibbert, and he draws the foul.
You know, character's got some good offensive skills on the inside. He's a young man who can be as good as he wants to be. It's all in his hands.
Monday, Rivalry Week, presented by Cisco, concludes with a great doubleheader here on ESPN. Villanova taking on these Georgetown Hoyas at 7 Eastern. And then what a matchup this should be down in Austin, Kansas and Texas at 9 Eastern.
You know, Dan, think how significant that is on Monday. I mean, we talk about it, you can't pass it off lightly. Here's a club that shoots 23 attempts per game shooting the three, and here we're at the 3-minute mark in the first half, and they haven't attempted one. The reason? Defense. You got to credit Georgetown for really understanding how important it is to play that three-point line.
The Hoy is about as good as it gets at executing a game plan, and it all starts on the defensive end, really, for both of these teams. Ewing forced to handle and get it over the timeline.
You know, Georgetown doesn't really blow people away, but they are 9-1 in conference play, and they always find a way, it seems, to win.
Their only losses this year at Memphis and at Pittsburgh. Oh, there's a foul, sure. Yeah, Terrence.
He's holding him.
He had a piece of the jersey.
He's holding him. Yeah. Trying to throw a diagonal pass. Hey, you mentioned the Vols. Tennessee, to me, is the only real threat to beat Memphis, and we'll be there for that game. Personally, I think Memphis, because they're playing at home and they don't have to really emotionally get involved in every game, let's say, like teams like Tennessee and people they play in their pre-conference schedule, I think Memphis goes 34-0
wow.
Entering the tournament. First unblemished record since Jerry Tarkanian in 1991.
2 weeks from tonight, we'll be down in Memphis. Gameday will be there for the Vols and the Tigers. Tennessee got a late steal and a layup today from Juwan Smith.
Oh, look at that.
Left-handed hook shot by Hibbert. Tennessee beat LSU by 2.
Hold on, let me talk. Wait.
Well, I know you want to talk.
Hold on, let me talk about LSU. I think shame on you firing a coach in the middle of the season because of W's and L's. Give me a break. What is college becoming? I mean, the NBA level. Now finish your story. I'm sorry.
No, that was my story.
It was?
I was handing it off to you.
You were?
I know I got to feed you the rock.
That's a three.
Happy. First attempt from beyond the arc tonight. But a great win for Tennessee. It was a charged environment down in Baton Rouge. The kids for LSU played their hearts out. But you got to wonder how they react with a coach fired in the middle of the season.
Well, you know, I really have a problem with that. I mean, as you can watch, a little left-hand hook by Hibbert on the inside showing versatility. I really mean it. I think Oregon State as well. I really say shame on you in both programs. You fire a coach, moral reasons, ethic reasons, a walk in the backcourt, but not because of W's and L's in the middle of the season.
Mistake by the freshman there, Freeman. You can't walk the baseline unless there's been a made basket, and that turns it back over to Louisville. Wow, the Cardinals, it's amazing they're within 7.
They got to make a three somehow to get some momentum. They got to make a three, but look at Georgetown now. They're in the zone. They play about 20% zone, 80% man-to-man. They should get a three out of this zone. They should be able to catch right in the gap right there for an open shot.
Got a good look, Earl Clark did. Every point the Cardinals have, either in the paint or from the line.
Played with such poise on the road. This crowd was ready to be so ruckus here tonight. to rock and roll. Georgetown silences the crowd, gets the early lead.
Their expressions never change. They run the clock. They kind of wear you down bit by bit. They're happy to play you even for 35 minutes because they think they'll own the last five.
They find a way to win. They got a winner's mentality. Certain players can be spectacular, but they don't understand how to win.
Jerry Smith, a good look. Got it.
They need that. That gives you momentum. That gives you a lift. The first three they made tonight. I said it early, and I'll say it again. If Louisville's to win, they're going to make the three.
Back within four. Nice feed and hit it all alone for the dunk.
I mean, are you serious giving a guy inside 7'2", that open look?
How do you lose a guy that big?
Wow.
7'2", 270, getting better and better, a real raw project. When he got to Georgetown as a freshman, he's turned himself into a potential lottery pick. Here they go again, Jerry Smith again.
He's the guy I was talking about earlier, capable of going on that run.
He has been shooting lights out the last seven or eight games for the Cardinals.
One of the biggest threes he ever made was to beat Marquette since he's from Wisconsin.
How about Austin Freeman with the answer at the other end?
Austin Freeman's going to be one heck of a player at Georgetown. Diaper dandy now in the starting lineup, giving them productive minutes.
All of a sudden, the lids come off the baskets here as it's raining threes the last couple of minutes.
Another key factor in this game thus far has been the solid play and not turning the ball over against Louisville, where Louisville could generate some offense. And you got to credit the backcourt of Sapp and Wallace.
7 seconds left. Character blocked by Hibbert. Time for the Hoyas. Freeman ahead of Palacios for the layup.
They run a little bit more this year, Georgetown. A little bit more out in transition. Solid first half defensively by Georgetown, only allowing 23 points on the road.
A good finish to the half for the Hoyas. Ewing ahead to Freeman. Georgetown leading Louisville by 8 at the break here in sold-out Freedom Hall. Louisville only takes 3 threes. They make 2, both in the last couple of minutes. They've only scored 23. Let's go to Aaron Anders with John Thompson the third.
All right, Dan, thanks. Coach, how have you been able to take Louisville out of their perimeter game?
Out of what? I'm sorry, I didn't hear you.
The perimeter game.
We've been attentive. We've just been lucky. They got a couple open shots there at the end. You know, we've been attentive to it. Our guys have done a good job of closing out, and we have to maintain that. They started to get a rhythm for how we were playing defense towards the latter parts, and they got a couple open looks.
You told me earlier today you were worried about their pressure. How has your team handled it so far?
I don't know. It's got to get better. You know, we had a few little mix-ups right there, mainly because we didn't get into what we wanted to. We didn't get into our sets. But we have to continue to protect the ball, and we have to somehow hopefully keep limiting their threes.
Coach, thank you.
Thank you.
Well, it's good, but it can always get better. Georgetown up 8 on Louisville. Coming up next from Louisville, the UPS Halftime Report with Reese, Hubert, Digger, and Jay. Welcome back to ESPN's Saturday Night Primetime, presented by DirecTV, a part of Rivalry Week, presented by Cisco. Georgetown leading Louisville by 8. What happened to the whiteout?
He changed his suit. He's a member of our old GQ team. I had to pick the best guys in terms of dress. There's the white suit. He doesn't want the white suit. He looks at the board. He's down. He says, time to change. John Thompson III could dress, too.
That's right.
He made my old GQ team as well.
You had your top 10, and they were both big-time members of it. What does Louisville have to do to play better in the second half?
Well, I think number one, they got to start getting some three-point opportunities to make some threes. They really do. That's vital in their offensive scheme. You average 23 threes a game. You only get 3 so far in this half. Made 2 out of the 3, but they got to get some looks, and they didn't happen until the last 2 minutes.
Didn't have a single offensive rebound, turned the ball over. They only attempted 16 shots in the first half. Georgetown attempted 27, but the Hoyas didn't go to the free throw line once in the first 20
because
minutes.
They're not really attacking off the dribble. They're not creating opportunities for the opportunity to go to free throw line, but I'll tell you one thing. They were suffocating on the defensive end.
Shot clock at 7. Hibbert, good position in deep over Padgett.
He could utilize that hook. A little Kareem, a little George Mikan. A little before your time, Mr. Mikan.
Oh, we just saw George Mikan, one of the top 25 on that list of the all-time top college basketball players that are counting down.
Played for the late Ray Meyer. Played for him at DePaul. Then went on for fame with the Lakers. Mm-hmm.
The Minneapolis.
Yes, sir.
Jerry Smith, a miss from the corner. And count the bucket. Good. Terrence Williams with a bucket. Let's take a look now at tonight's Cisco game track as we're early in the second half here at Freedom Hall.
It was an 8-point lead to the break for Georgetown. No second chance points, no offensive rebounds for Louisville. Turnover trouble, hardly took any threes. Maybe kind of fortunate to be down only 8, Dick.
Look at that right there, though. No free throw attempts either. How often have you seen that, especially for a team that's leading? I tell you, the Big East, Mike Trangisi in the house tonight. He's got to really be proud. This conference is so deep and so tough. When you look at teams on the bottom that really are struggling, I mean, Villanova gets a win today, but it just shows you Providence. They're all decent basketball team.
You know, St. John's is playing better now. They have won 3 in a row, picked up a win today.
Oh, Howie Schwab's happy to hear that. Howie in the house. St. John's graduate.
Let's check in with Aaron Andrews.
Dan, I had a chance to speak with some members of the Louisville coaching staff coming out of the locker room. What Rick Pitino was preaching there in the locker room, he said, look, let's play under control. Be a little bit more patient out there. They were out-rebounded 15-9 in the first half. That was something that bothered him a lot. As for the wardrobe update, a lot of people on the team telling me no idea why he went to the change of suit, but I was just told by somebody on Louisville staff, bad omen, guys. The white is out. Dark in.
What do you tell the 19,000 people who showed up here in white tonight?
I'll tell one thing, Aaron. I know why he changed. The scoreboard. Do you think it would change if he was up 8? No way, Aaron.
Down by 8 early in the second half. Williams all the way.
Nice drive by Williams. Got in the gap. Attacked the basket. Creating a little offense. Now they're trying to create some offense off their defense. Georgetown doing a great job, though. Handling the ball against the pressure. And playing with poise. I think you could describe Georgetown one simple word. Poise. Yeah. They never panic. They play under control.
And again, a reflection of the personality of their coach.
And you said earlier, they don't change the expression on their face.
And they've been there, done that. They can win on the road. They've been to a Final Four. 3 is short from the corner.
I think we're going to see a spurt by Louisville. I really do.
Magic.
Oh, score the basket. Yeah. I think we're going to see a spurt by Louisville. There seems to be a more bounce to the step. And it's all set by the genius on the sideline, Pitino. He knows how to motivate. Here they come. Here come the Cardinals. You can feel in the crowd is ready to roar.
Sure are. The trap, and they got it again. And Wallace commits the foul.
Wallace has got a long streak of starts. He has started every game since arriving out of Alabama as a walk, basically a walk-on.
Yep. His 124th consecutive start. That's the most for any current Division I player.
He's a terrific young man. He's a guy that's going to make it in life when the uniform comes on.
Yeah.
Just like one of the big people I mentioned earlier. Patrick, you think about what the John Sayre, what has he done in Sayre? When you think about Mutombo opening up a hospital, John Saunders went there with them and said it was an emotional situation.
Padgett. And it's going to be a foul. Jonathan Wallace wanted a tie-up, but instead, it's a foul against the Hoyas.
I mentioned earlier, Alonzo Mourning, all those guys do such a great job helping their communities. John Thompson III recruiting those kind of people as well.
Two quick fouls this half on Wallace. He'll sit down. He's the quarterback. He's the guy who really gets them going, although in their offense, a number of different people can handle and pass. The big guys can pass the ball as well, but he's really the guy who gets it started.
You want to see this house explode? If somehow Louisville can rotate out and get a three-point shot to go down, this place would explode. They're building a new building.
That's right. Going to be a new downtown facility in about 3 years.
That means Kentucky's going to build a new one a little better. And if you can do, we can do better.
Well, I'll tell you, I've been to Louisville's practice facility that they opened up in August. It is spectacular a few blocks away from here. Georgetown in the 2-3 zone. Hibbert in the middle. Good position for Clark. And it goes.
Nice left-handed move. Quickness. Oral Clark in the post. Came out, heralded out of New Jersey. Look at a little bounce now to the defensive pressure. The 2-2-1 press. A trap. There's the rotation.
Rivers gets it over. And now Rivers, Freeman, and Sapp, the three guys in the backcourt for the Hoyas as they set up and look for a high percentage shot. That's not it.
Might have been a pass.
Hibbert the miss. Louisville ball.
Trying to get out in transition. Good job defensively by Georgetown getting back.
Clark stripped. got it back under the rim, and Hibbert blocks him without leaving his feet.
It's that great 7-2, baby. You can't teach that.
Averaging better than two blocks per game. Freeman with the floater. Beautifully done.
He knows how to score. He's got a variety of ways he can score. He will be a big scorer at Georgetown eventually.
Just a freshman. He'll have a much larger role on next year's team.
The NCAA Women's Basketball Championship coming in March. Bud Light is brewed to give you everything you want in a beer. Never-ending refreshment, superior drinkability, and now, the ability to talk to animals.
Hey there, boy. How was your day?
Sausages. Plenty sausages. Sausage.
Good talk.
Sausages.
The ability to talk to animals no longer available in Bud Light.
Sausage.
The endless refreshment, however, remains.
Bud Light keeps it coming.
What's on your mind, little buddy?
Mind your own business, chump.
Sausage.
Oh, it's gonna be a doozy. So were you able to get all your technology specialists on the line?
Great. Hey, guys. All right, I did everything you guys recommended, but I just want to go over things one last time. Okay, backup power. Check. Data. Check. Connectivity. Yeah, check. All right, I'm good to go.
With trained specialists to solve your most complex IT needs.
Beautiful.
We're there. CDW.
Bob, yeah, we're going to need to replace a few things.
Oil. Energy. The environment. It is the story of our time, and it leaves no one untouched. Because this is about you and me and the other 6.5 billion people on this planet who need energy. So for today, the world needs oil. But what is also true is that we can provide it more intelligently, more efficiently, more respectfully, that we can practice and espouse conservation. Yes, we are an oil company, but right now we're also providing natural gas, solar, geothermal. Because we live on this planet too. Not corporate titans, but people who daily try to find newer ways, cleaner ways to power the world. Imagine that. An oil company is part of the solution. This is the power of human energy.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by Cisco. Welcome to the Human Network. And Sonic. It's not just good, it's Sonic good.
Welcome back to Louisville. Dan Schulman, Dick Vitale, Aaron Anders, and the Game Day Gang all here for Saturday primetime, presented by DirecTV. Louisville with a nice run here in the second half. That's a chicken and egg kind of thing. Are they playing better, or is it the white suit going away and being replaced by the black suit that's making them play better here in the second half?
Well, I don't think the suit has anything to do with it, but they're playing a lot better. There's a little execution. Great pass by Padgett. The release. You see a little bit more spark defensively. I told you, my friend, they were going to be back. You could feel it. You could feel it. You've been around the game for years. Oh, it's a foul in the backcourt. Oh, he fouled him. He said, who, me? Absolutely.
Timeout on the floor here at the Freedom Hall. The momentum has shifted firmly in the direction of the Cardinals. How about this? They're lighting it up with Pitino in the dark suit. They're back with it, too.
That's the Italian look.
Let's go get him. Good luck.
Ace car is off.
NASCAR Nationwide Series at Daytona. Coverage begins next Saturday with the Camping World 300 on ESPN2.
Get ready for an explosion of indescribably crunchy, cheesy flavor. It's the new crunchy, cheesy crust pizza from Pizza Hut. Cheese baked right onto the crust for a crunch that unlocks a flavor shockwave. Try one now for just $11.99. And now get two free bottles of new G2 from Gatorade when you buy a crunchy, cheesy crust pizza. Get more, not less. Pizza Hut. Order online.
Who do the right thing. They call it being responsible. When it's a car insurance company, they call it Liberty Mutual. Responsibility. What's your policy? Liberty Mutual.
Do I know anything about freedom funds? What?
Nothing. Talk.
Okay. Well, the closer you get to retirement, the more your investments should shift away from long-term things like stocks into shorter-term things like bonds and cash. I know.
I'm really not interested.
Freedom Fund does it automatically.
Any of it.
It's all in one fund.
Nothing.
Yeah, okay.
Check out a Fidelity Freedom Fund for your IRA. Call 1-800-FIDELITY. Before investing, consider the fund's investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses. Contact Fidelity for prospectus containing this information. Read it carefully.
I just want my daughter back.
It's all right, we're going to find
her. One of the best films of the year.
How much?
And nominated for an Academy Award Best Supporting Actress.
Tell him I'm sorry.
The movie that will leave you talking long after it's over. Gone Baby Gone. Own it on DVD and Blu-ray. High def February 12th.
This ESPN telecast is available in dramatic high definition on ESPN HD. Presented by Olivia. Welcome back to Freedom Hall. It's all Cardinals here in the second half. Back within two. Saturday primetime presented by DirecTV.
Happy birthday! I mean, unbelievable! Happy birthday, Dad!
It actually happens about once a year. Hey! I'm going to eat it, not wear it. Thank you.
Look at that beautiful kid.
That is nice.
Wow! Look
Who
at
told
that,
you?
Dad. 41 years old.
Thanks.
I would do anything to be 41 again. Happy birthday,
Thank
Dad.
Thank you. You know the best
part?
You have
many more.
I'm on the road, it seems, every year for my birthday.
And I'm here with you.
And every year I get a cake from you. I get more from you than I get at home. It's great.
I'm with you on your birthday instead of your wife.
Wow. You going to share some of that with me?
Absolutely. I'm sharing it.
You're wearing some of it already. You got a whole group with you who wants part of that. You got your son-in-law here. We got Howie Schwab here. You got your doctors here.
Yeah, doctors. Hotels is in the house.
We're checking up on you and making sure that you're doing okay. Thumbs up so far, Doc. All right, we got Dr. Zeitels, we got Dr. Hillman,
Dr. Deems,
we got the whole staff here from Boston and Sarasota.
Well, you know, Dr. Zeitels is the Tom Brady of the voice business.
That's
and
him
Dr.
In the middle,
Deems
right?
yep. is a young rising star, and Dr. Hillman is a scientific genius. I don't know what they're going to find out testing my vocal cords, but he did it with Steven Tyler and Errol Smith. Now, do you follow that?
I love Steven Tyler.
Oh, yeah.
Now, here's pregame. This is how Dick gets ready for the game. I can't remember what this device is called, but they're monitoring the stress on your vocal cords. They seem to be under the impression you put some stress. I tell you, can I just say one thing? I won't sleep tonight now.
Oh, it's amazing.
But they're taking care of you, and they all seem very pleased with how you're sounding so far here tonight. And they got front row seats to a basketball game.
Exactly. They get a chance to see their people up close.
Yeah, and some birthday cake. Big night. And we got a good game. Georgetown leading by four. Number six in the nation. 19-2, the Hoyas are. Taking on Louisville, 17-6.
Nice pass. Great look. They're releasing, getting layups. Because the defensive people are there. Has a turnover almost in the backcourt.
Oh, Rick Pitino thought that should have been Cardinal ball.
See, the defense is staring at the basketball. You got to watch ball, you man. Little breakdown. Look, watch this right here. The defense stares. He releases. Paget gets an easy layup. I love the way he goes without the basketball. Yeah. Sets that screen, releases off the screen.
He's got 13 points tonight, the high score in the game.
Look at their hands. All active in the defense. Playing that zone. Trying to take away passing lanes.
Paget, also the guy that Coach Pitino says he's the quarterback on defense. He'll tell everybody else where they're supposed to be, and if they don't get there, he'll physically push them to the right spot on the floor.
Can't get any layups, though, in transition. They get back so quick, Georgetown.
Macklin on Paget right now.
Paget, a good passer.
And a push on Macklin.
You know, you think of Rick Pitino, the only coach to take three different teams to the Final Four. He took the Friars, led by Billy Donovan. He had Kentucky win the national title. He took Louisville already in 2005. He's only one of four coaches to take four different schools to the NCAA tournament.
Tonight is his 700th game as a collegiate coach.
Hey, Mr. Smith. Mr. Smith is here. Mr. Smith's in the house with the trifecta.
Three threes tonight for Jerry Smith, and the Cardinals have the lead.
Hibbert on the bench right now. Mr. Schumann, I told you 3 minutes
You're
ago,
right.
they're going to go on a spur.
We'll never see the white suit again, Dick. It'll never come out of the closet again.
Give it an auction. Make a lot of money for the V Foundation. We're auctioning it off.
Wallace, little strong. Palacios.
Momentum, Uncle Mo, right now on the side of the Cardinals.
And the rebound down to Ewing and the missed three by Sosa.
I like what Ewing's doing coming off that bench. He gives him energy, he gives him enthusiasm, and he gives him productivity.
But again, Georgetown won't change, won't panic. They'll just keep probing for a good shot.
A lot of patience as well. All reflecting John Thompson III, one of the young stars in coaching.
A foul before the shot. It'll go on Padgett as we check in with Aaron Andrews.
Dan, and talking about head coach Rick Pitino and the battles he's been in, what a battle he was in 87. He was the head coach, obviously, of Providence. John Thompson, the head coach at Georgetown. And there's a big game that year where it was a very physical game. There was a hard foul, I was told, in that game. And John Thompson came charging half court at Rick Pitino. Well, I'm told by Rick Pitino's son, Richard and Ryan, tonight that Rick Pitino had no choice but to charge right back. They got in an altercation, pointing at each other. And Rick Pitino's son is telling me after the game, they made amends. John Thompson saying, I love what you're doing with my alma mater. Thank you. They are friends now. John Thompson actually getting one of the Pitino boys into Georgetown. So all is well.
Well, two of the great coaches in college basketball. And that's Big John, John Jr., that Aaron's talking about 6'11", 260. Imagine Pitino rushing at Big John with something on his mind.
You know, I really think the world of Rick Pitino, and I think at that moment, not too smart. I mean, John Thompson, the heavyweight champ. Yeah.
Padgett, with no Hibbert in the game, Padgett is going right into the post and looking for a foul right there, and Mike Kitch disagrees.
The one thing I like about Padgett, he wants the rock. He wants to make sure as Hibbert comes back on the floor. They've only got two field goals here in this half.
The Cardinals have already made as many field goals in the second half in 7.5 minutes as they made in the entire first half. A lot on the line here with Georgetown leading the Big East at 9-1. Notre Dame is at 8-2. Connecticut and Louisville each at 7-3.
Louisville rising 7-3 because the composition of their team has changed. They got a healthy group. Palacios and Padgett in the lineup.
Summers misses the 12-footer. Rebound Palacios.
Palacios gives him a lot of experience. He's a 1,000-point scorer. He's had a battle all kinds of injuries in his career. Here's a key for Louisville. If they're going to really make a run come Final Four on March Madness, Sosa's got to really be productive on that perimeter.
He and McGee sharing the minutes at the point. Palacios wearing a brace on his right knee because of all the trouble he's had.
See, part of the game plan is to challenge these threes, but Sosa knocks it down. He made 3 out of 4 against Marquette, had 18 points and a big win up in Milwaukee where they gave Marquette their first loss at home. This place is loud now. Oh, turnover city. Uncle Mo, get it to you, baby. John T, get it to you. There's the white out. Pitino says, I don't have to be in white.
I'll stop the world and melt with you. You seen the difference.
Inspiration pulled from your life. That's professional grade. That's the Acadia from GMC. With refined styling, available overhead sky views, and the smooth ride of a luxury sedan, Acadia is helping to redefine the category. Welcome to Acadia, the crossover from GMC.
ABC, your NBA Sunday destination. The game's elite take center stage. First, Tim Duncan and the Spurs face the league-leading Celtics. Then, Kobe Bryant, Paul Gasol, and the explosive Lakers battle the Heat. Coverage begins tomorrow at 12:30 Eastern.
Dan Snyder gets his man. Who's his unlikely choice to run the Redskins? Rich Rodriguez tells West Virginia fans to stop the death threats and why Tony Stewart punched Kurt Busch in the face at Daytona. It's SportsCenter after the game.
I've always wanted to have a pool. To me, that was my dream.
If you've ever dreamed of the perfect swim, for exercise, fun with your family, or relaxation at the end of the day, order a free DVD or video to learn more about the endless pool, your personal pool at home.
nice and small, compact.
A regular pool, first of all, you have turns that you have to concentrate on. Here, it's endless. You're swimming in place, which is a great opportunity to be able to work on your stroke technique.
It's in your basement. Run downstairs, turn it on, you're there. It's like having a treadmill in your basement.
You know, I'll come downstairs and there'll be sometimes seven or eight kids in the pool and they're always grabbing onto the bar, cranking it all the way up.
Indoors or outside?
Call 800-319-9705 or visit our website for a free DVD.
Ryan Burr with your SportsCenter 30 at 30 update. The Redskins have hired Jim Zorn as their new head coach, a surprise ending to a month-long search to replace Joe Gibbs. Former Seahawks quarterback will be introduced tomorrow. Number 19, UConn, looking for seven in a row. Got the best of Georgia Tech. Hashim to beat, 24 points, 15 rebounds, six block shots. And Wisconsin down 14 to Purdue.
Now, Purdue, a big story. They're looking at sole possession atop the Big Ten standings. And if you want to check them out firsthand, they got a big game against Michigan State Tuesday night on ESPN, part of Super Tuesday.
I'll tell you, Matt Painter, talk about a guy that could be up there for National Coach of the Year, yeah. Even though I'd give that edge to Keno Davis for the job he's done down at Drake. Dr. Tom's going to be proud of his son. Got so many former coaches' sons, one here tonight, yeah. Mr. Thompson.
Padgett, nice look. Clark for three. Long rebound to Smith. Nice pass, Palacios.
There's Smith with the great pass. He's already made four threes tonight. He made that big one before the timeout, Smith did. He's got all four of their threes, I believe, right there.
You're right. Louisville was down eight at the break. They have outscored Georgetown by 14 here in the second half.
And one of the reasons their defense has really been the king. They got a little bit more bounce to the step. It's getting them to play a little better offensively. They're moving better without the ball.
Remember, Rick Pitino told us pregame, this is the toughest ticket for a Louisville basketball game since he came here in the last 7 or 8 years. The fans were waiting for this one, a chance to go to 3-0 against ranked teams on the season. Stripped away by Clark.
Their defense has really come alive here in the second half. Louisville, a different basketball team. It's not just about the black suit, even though that gives him the better look, especially Italian-wise. I mean, he's got that Italian look now. A little Tony Soprano look there. That's with right. That black suit.
Sosa, Padgett, and a foul. And Rick Pitino loves it, loves the ball movement by the Cardinals. Well, you can see the Hoyas again on a Monday night as Rivalry Week presented by Cisco concludes with a doubleheader here on ESPN. Georgetown will host Villanova at 7 Eastern and then at 9 Eastern to Kansas, which beat Baylor tonight 100-90.
Wow.
Will take on Texas. The Longhorns needed overtime to win at Iowa State today.
And Memphis keeps marching on. Their only real threat, as we said, a game we'll have against the Tennessee Vols. Lofton really starting to shoot the ball well for Tennessee.
Other big games today. Washington State got a lopsided win against USC, beat them by 24. Duke got big games out of Kyle Singler and DeMarcus Nelson to beat BC 90-80. Kentucky won again. They beat Alabama. Now, they were so bad early in the season, but they're playing so much better now. And you wonder how, if they continue to play well, might they have a shot at an at-large?
I'll tell you this. Kentucky got healthy. They bought into the defensive system of Billy Gillespie. And then they got the third factor. The SEC is really not vintage SEC this season. So there's a lot of chances for some W's. But the SEC will be back. I mean, it'll be one of the upper echelon conferences again.
Jerry Smith the foul, his second.
They get great recruits, great coaches. Hey, I'm hearing a crazy rumor that maybe LSU's going to go after Tim Floyd since he's from Louisiana.
You heard that?
Yeah, really? Hearing rumors. Yeah,
I got to tell you, in your time away, you were working the phones. You were picking up all kinds of valuable information.
Even though I say shame on you down at LSU, yeah. Talked about it earlier, firing a coach during the middle of the season. There's that active zone. Yeah. Oh, this foul contact.
Ewing got character in the air.
They don't go to the free throw line often when you think about the Hoyas. I mean, they've only really, when you think about it, gone to the line coming into this game 30 more times than their opponents.
And only twice in the entire game tonight. Made them both. That was Freeman. This is Ewing. A couple of years at Indiana, now a senior at Georgetown after transferring. And a guy who's used to getting a lot of abuse from visiting crowds simply because he's Patrick Ewing's son, but he brushes it off beautifully. He's his own man, and he plays his own style. He's a very valuable player on this team.
I heard some fan during halftime saying, "Hey, Ewing, you're not like your dad. You know what? There weren't anybody like his dad,
right.
So don't have to worry about that." On a collegiate level, he was as dominant as he came in terms of the post, and he is, to me, a lock for the Hall of Fame, the Naismith Hall of Fame, since he's eligible this year.
Clark right at Hibbert, and it's out of bounds to Georgetown. Louisville by 7 after trailing by 8 at the half. The Hoyas have gone scoreless for better than 6 minutes.
Georgetown's not really an explosive offensive team. They're not a club that can fall behind by a big number and then all of a sudden just come back.
Good trap on Jesse Sapp.
You don't want to reach in a foul. They get the timeout, Georgetown. They get the 30-second timeout.
So the Hoyas continue to struggle. Just 6 points here in the second half, looking at a 7-point deficit against Louisville.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. You know, it's great being here. Talking to Rick Pitino before the game, you and I, we're going to honor Rick next year with Billy Donovan. That's going to be our Dick Vitale Gala headliners. This year, we're honoring Pat Summitt, and we're honoring Bob Knight, and tickets are flying away. You cannot believe I just got a table ordered by Manny Jackson for the Globetrotters,
really?
A whole table. As a look, save the date, May 16th. Call 1-800-4-JIMMY-V, or you can go to my website, DickVitaleOnline.com, and Dan, you know about my motivational tapes.
Yep.
I'm going to give my proceeds to the V Foundation. They're selling big time, and they're available as well on my website, DickVitaleOnline.com. And again, we want to raise money to beat cancer, and I can't thank the coaches enough. Roy Williams is coming. John Gruden's coming. Eddie Sutton's coming.
Now, last year, correct me if I'm wrong, we raised $1.3 million, right? Mike Krzyzewski was there down at the Ritz in beautiful Sarasota. And with Bobby Knight and Pat Summitt there this year, looking to equal or try to better that number.
We got a surprise who's going to introduce Bob Knight and a surprise who's going to introduce Pat Summitt.
Wow.
They're going to bring the house down.
And John Saunders will be your MC.
Oh, he's the MC. Does a terrific job. You did a great job for us. But now you've gone to the NBA.
No, we can't get a look at you. I just pinch hit for John. John is the man.
Well, two Canadians.
That's right.
You guys have been great.
Smith out, Knowles in.
John's a dear friend, and so are you.
Thank you very much. It was great. Mike Krzyzewski did a phenomenal job last year helping to raise money. It's a great night down at a beautiful hotel in Sarasota for a terrific cause.
What about the friend of Rick Pitino who donated $100,000 to go to a game, Chris Sullivan from Outback fame. There's that zone. I tell you, they've done a great job, Louisville, the second half. 6 points thus far they've allowed. There's eight.
Sapp finds Rivers for the layup. It's a 5-point game.
Jeremiah, solid player, getting better and better. Tough defensively, a communicator on the court. He's a leader. His dad was so special as a player and is as a coach.
Well, and they've got a big one tomorrow, taking on San Antonio on ABC as we go to the under 8 timeout here in Louisville. The Cardinals have had a terrific second half. Rick Pitino may not be part of the whiteout anymore, but everybody in the crowd is. And the Cardinals trying to beat the number 6 Hoyas here at Freedom Hall.
Louisville Sluggers baseball. Louisville Sluggers.
Like zoinks, it's the cable guy.
Well, now that DirecTV has way more HD channels than cable, he had to try to stop everyone from switching to DirecTV.
Get over 90 of the best channels in HD now on DirecTV.
Our engineers had a mission. Give Sierra more power, more performance, and examine everything that makes a Sierra a Sierra. Mission accomplished. The 2008 Sierra from GMC. The available 5.3-liter V8 offers 315 horsepower and the best V8 fuel economy of any full-size pickup. The Sierra from GMC. Just because it hasn't been done doesn't mean it can't be done.
That guy already knows what this is. Because you're not that guy, there's Helzberg Diamonds, where you could learn this is a graduated diamond journey pendant with 7-round brilliant cut diamonds, now specially priced at just $99.99. Helzberg Diamonds, helping regular guys since 1915.
Thank you.
New gear. You need it? We've got it.
Bass Pro Shops has the latest gear at the lowest price guaranteed. And for a limited time, you can get a gift card worth up to $1,000 with select 2008 Tracker and Nitro boats. Bass Pro Shops. Your adventure starts here.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is presented by DirecTV, must-have equipment for any sports fan, and in part by GMC. We are professional grade.
Back in Louisville, where the Cardinals are shooting 52% against the Hoyas, who lead the nation in opponent's field goal percentage, and Louisville is up five. Hey, you talked about Pat Summitt being one of the guests of honor, along with Bob Knight of the V Foundation dinner down in Sarasota. Well, we'll see Pat Summitt at the Lady Vols, and knee permitting, Candace Parker in a rematch of the national championship game. Big Monday women's action presented by Bud Light, 7 Eastern on ESPN2.
And Vivian Stringer does a phenomenal job down at Rutgers, has the big win over Gino Auriemma in Connecticut.
Knowles and Sosa in the backcourt right now for the Cardinals. It's been a great second half for Louisville, turning an 8-point deficit into a 5-point lead.
Tell you one thing, Jesse Sapp's been quiet tonight. 6 consecutive games, double figures, only has a deuce tonight.
Boy, almost unstoppable when he gets where he wants to go.
He does a great job with that hook shot. That's a really lost shot. You don't see many big players utilizing the hook.
A dozen for Hibbert. Remember how well he played against Aaron Gray, who's now in the NBA in the Big East tournament last year, how well he played against Greg Oden in the NCAA tournament, although Georgetown lost.
You know, you mentioned Pittsburgh, and you talk about certainly Gray, but what a tough break losing those two guys, yeah. Cook and Fields. And what about Syracuse? Jimmy Boeheim's kids suffered some big losses with Diefendorf out.
The good news for Pitt is Fields should be back by the end of the month. He has been cleared to start practicing. Knowles in the air, releases the shot, and draws the foul.
Rick Pitino lights up when he talks about Knowles, his hustle, his scrappiness. Hey, this guy can flat out coach. It all started at five-star camp as a young 22-year-old. Howard Garfinkel's camp gave him that opportunity. Then he went to Hawaii, started there, and then on his honeymoon,
said, right.
Forget about it, I'm joining Jimmy Boeheim. Boeheim took precedent over his beautiful wife, Joe. Are you kidding me? Have you seen Boeheim and Rick's wife? I mean, are you giving up your honeymoon for Boeheim? Something's not right.
Knowles, kind of a lightly recruited guy by this standard, this level of basketball. His other offer was from VCU, but as you said, Rick Pitino saw something that he liked about him. And boy, if you're tenacious on D, Rick Pitino's going to love you.
You mentioned VCU. What about the job Anthony Grant's doing down there? That's going to be a tough guy for them to keep him. He's going to be a wanted guy.
Look at Knowles. They're in his zone, but look at him way out. Pounding the ball.
Well, he knows if he wants any PT at all playing time, he better show the coach that he's going to scrap defensively. They're active in that zone. They really are very active, making it difficult for them to get some good shots as the turnover.
Knowles with a steal. Sosa has it blocked by Sapp.
Great play by Sapp defensively. Most guys would have fouled in that situation. Sapp's going to make some shots.
Terrence Williams comes up with a block.
Move is a different club defensively here in the second half.
Yeah, whatever Coach Pitino said in the locker room, he lit a fire under his Cardinals. And he had time to deliver a speech and change his clothes at halftime.
Take it up strong. He waited. I like the unselfishness of T. Williams. I like his maturity as a player. We saw him take so many bad shots as we're watching Sapp with that great defensive effort. He had the great angle for the block shot there.
Adds it to the line now for the Cardinals.
Tell you, talk about Smith and Padgett. They've combined for 28 points. The rest of the club, 17. Gives you a grand total, 45.
There you go. As you said, they're both of these teams are very balanced. Neither one of these teams has a player in the top 20 in scoring in the Big East Conference.
Well, here, guys, they're leading scorers like 13 to 14 a game, and they each have five guys in double figures. But I make that comparison, winning national titles, Billy Donovan's club, Torian Green led the Gators in scoring at 14 a game. And to put that into a certain picture, think about it, they have three guys drafted in the top nine, but they sacrificed all about winning.
Well, Jeff Green last year, the Big East Player of the Year, picked fifth overall in the NBA draft, 13 points a game. How about a guy sitting in a nice suit over beside Rick Pitino, one of his assistants now, played for him at Kentucky,
Walter McCarty.
He keeps preaching to the Louisville players how deep that team was, how they all thought about the team over themselves, and how all of them went on to have professional careers.
Well, Walter McCarty played 7.5 years for the Boston Celtics. Celtics, I love the job Danny Ainge and Doc are doing with that club.
Squeaked out a two-pointer win last night without Garnett up in Minneapolis. Another Georgetown turnover.
Can't get any good looks against that zone. Really having a difficult time attacking it. Not getting the kind of ball movement they want.
And Dick, something you hardly ever see. A little grimacing, a little barking between the Hoya players. You never see that, but the Cardinals return the favor by turning it right back over.
See, right now you got to get some ball movement against the zone. Now they rotate. Now they're going to stay with the zone.
Hibbert not in the game right now for Georgetown.
Got to find some gaps. See, the way they're passing the basketball, the defense can easily slide and adjust to every movement.
And the clock runs quickly in a Georgetown game because they take so much time on each possession. With a travel.
Turning it over. The defense, as we watch this crowd, oh, they fired up. Look at the defense here on Padgett. Padgett's going to try to use what we call the spin reverse move on the inside. Single reverse. They throw the lob up. But the defense really anticipates well.
14 turnovers committed tonight by the Hoyas. Nice pass inside from Williams to Padgett.
Good adjustment though defensively by Georgetown.
Clark for three.
Got it! Big. Oh, that's big. That's going to bring the house down. Mr. Clark from the perimeter. He's got a lot of good skills. I hope he stays in school. He's not ready physically for the NBA.
The first Cardinal other than Smith to make a three tonight.
Louisville team getting better and better. Their confidence. This is a much better team than you saw earlier this year.
Summers can't answer.
Look at the hustle, the scrap. Nothing like college basketball, my friends. The passion, the unbelievable intensity, the emotion. 29 years, I've had the right and the privilege to sit at courtside and see so many great games. Can't thank my bosses enough.
Fourth largest crowd in Freedom Hall history is here tonight, 20,083.
They love their basketball in this state, I'll tell you that.
After trailing by 8 at halftime, Louisville now leads by 9 with just over 4 minutes to go.
And you watch when Billy Gillespie gets his kind of players down there in Kentucky, it will be absolutely unbelievable how dominant they will be because he will be a workaholic in recruiting.
Williams trying to shake Rivers.
Williams got great size for a passer. Rivers, good defensive player, right up on him.
A point forward, 6'6", 220, spectacular athlete.
Rivers doing a great job getting over the top of screens. Never going fourth man.
Padgett left hand. And size. It's Hoya ball.
Size bothered him right there. Yep. Hibbert's size really altered that shot. See, there's no stat for altered shots.
Not a single made three in the second half of the Hoyas. Timeout, Georgetown.
Louisville playing well, but we talked about it during the game day show. I personally think Connecticut's play right now, they're the best team in the Big East. The way they're playing because of the unbelievable growth of Tabi.
Well, so many great games in the past few days. In case you missed it, here's a review of some of the best rivalry week had to offer.
Remember, he had a bank three to beat Southern Illinois.
From the corner, Campbell. Butler's got the lead.
Quentin Thomas running.
There it is.
There's Hansbrough blocked from behind.
Paulison keep the ball out of his hands. Paulus goes into the corner and makes a huge three. What a clutch shot. Ramon for the win. Got it. Pittsburgh wins. Now Gordon rises up over Brock. Oh! Gordon, the bank is open. Winding down, Lavender to the goal. The tip is good.
Not a bad few days of basketball, huh?
I'll tell you one thing. You talk about the greatest rivalries in all of sports. I mean, obviously, on a professional level, you think the Yankees and the Red Sox. College-wise, I got to go Edge, North Carolina, Duke. Then you think about Auburn and Alabama in football, Michigan and Ohio State in football, Louisville and Kentucky in basketball.
Sack right as the shot clock was expiring,
and that was big. He's been struggling offensively here tonight. Came in with six consecutive games in double figures.
He realized it just in time. He was not planning that. He forced it up because he had to and found the bottom of the net. Nice feed inside from Padgett to Clark, who misses the chippy but gets it back.
Great second effort by Clark. Should have had the jam on the first one, but he stayed with it.
And it seems just about every good possession for the Cardinals, Dick, Padgett gets a touch somehow, somewhere. Driving is Freeman, anticipating is Clark.
I am so impressed with the defensive ability and the effort as a team and the way they're unified, functioning together here in the second half by Louisville. Maybe it's the suit. I don't know. Maybe it's that black suit.
Minus eight in the white suit. +16 in the black suit.
Some other coaches are going to try to change in suits now. That's going to become a fad. You know, if you don't have players, you can change all the suits you want.
An 8-point lead for the Cardinals. If they win, they go to 8-3. Georgetown would fall to 9-2 in conference play. Notre Dame is right there at 8-2. Connecticut is at 7-3. The Big East is a bear this year. And imagine what the Big East tournament is going to be like in New York. We've got more Big East action coming your way on a Monday night as Villanova takes on these Hoyas at 7 Eastern. Pittsburgh and Marquette have had some phenomenal games in the last couple of years. And you and I are lucky enough we'll be in Bloomington, Indiana, 1 week
now
from
tonight. I can't wait to see Eric Gordon. It looks like Tom Izzo's got a tough week heading to Indiana, the state with Purdue. Yep. And then he also goes to Hoosier country down here. Boy, Eric Gordon really had to take some heat down in Illinois. Really nice, at least the Illinois administration apologized for some of the action. Most of the fans are great, but you get a few psychos who really go a step aboard. Same thing happened in Oregon.
That's right.
When Kevin Love had to go face it. All he did was go out and just dominate. He had 42 points and 39 rebounds in two games in the state of Oregon. Nice catch.
Sapp got him from behind. Padgett has it back, stolen away by Wallace.
You know, he got him from behind, but again, it was the presence of Hibbert that created that situation.
Oh, Wallace didn't see Hibbert. He had beaten Padgett down the floor. Again, Georgetown not used to having to score quickly.
That's not their game.
That's not their game. They tried it there, and it didn't work.
Their game is to dictate tempo by having the lead and dictate each possession.
No basket. The foul on Ewing way out of the perimeter. The Hoyas, can they answer here in the last minute and a half? I'll stop the world and melt with you.
You seem the inspiration pulled from your life. That's professional grade. That's the Acadia from GMC. With precise handling and the smooth ride of a luxury sedan, Acadia is helping to redefine the category. Welcome to Acadia, the crossover from GMC.
So how many times do I have to tell you? Don't leave these on the beach. Yeah.
Accomplish more with the HP SmartBuy 6710B notebook from CDW. It offers an Intel dual-core processor, a widescreen display, and comprehensive security. For the latest in HP notebooks, we're there, CDW.
This Valentine's Day, give the sweetest of American traditions, Whitman's chocolate, the Whitman Sampler Heart, an American favorite since 1842.
Intensity of Rivalry Week boils over on its last night. One of the most bitter Big East rivalries, Villanova clashes with Georgetown Monday at 7. Then, the biggest game in the Big 12, Kansas versus Texas at 9.
Dan Snyder gets his man. Who's his unlikely choice to run the Redskins? Rich Rodriguez tells West Virginia fans to stop the death threats and why Tony Stewart punched Kurt Busch in the face at Daytona. It's SportsCenter after the game.
Ryan Byrne, the studio, with his update from the Big Ten. Number 8, Wisconsin, 50-2 at home in the Big Ten, but trailing to Purdue. Robbie Hummel hits the three, 59-53. Purdue on top, about 7 minutes to go. Dan and Dick.
I'm telling you what, Ryan, that Tuesday night game between the Spartans and the Boilermakers is must-watch TV, isn't it?
I'll tell you, it'll be really a terrific game. Tom Izzo does a great job down here. He's going to get Knights on the roll. Hey, think about this. How good has the defensive effort of Louisville in the second half been? Georgetown, we're talking Georgetown, top 10 in America, 13 points thus far in the second half, 13.
Jerry Smith at the line for Louisville, the sharpshooter on this team with 4 made threes tonight. Continues a streak, really, of several weeks where he has shot the ball exceedingly well.
You know, Georgetown was able to escape in tough games with Connecticut, West Virginia, overtime, Syracuse, nipping those clubs to get W's. Got to be tough for them to get out of here with a W the way Louisville is playing defensively.
Louisville by 9 as we check in with Aaron.
Dan, say what you want about Rick Pitino's wardrobe change. He has said we are now a better team because of David Pageant. And one thing he told me yesterday, he has never had a big guy as vocal and assertive as David Pageant. If guys aren't doing what he wants, he will literally grab them by the throat and let them know what he needs. Pitino says that has made all the difference this season with his return.
And I'll tell you something, credit this crowd. They got the line, the whiteout. They really rose to the occasion here in the second half.
It should stay here, and it does. Hoya ball with 16 to shoot. A sensational second half of basketball by the Louisville Cardinals.
He's a motivator. He's a master motivator. Pat Forty, one of my favorite guys with ESPN.com, is a writer's year. He's doing a book with Pitino on motivation.
Give it a go. Ewing lays it in, and we'll have a chance for a three-point play.
You don't have to foul. Pitino upset with that. I tell you, I look down there. I see Pat Forty. I see Rick Bosich, another one of my favorites, columnist in town. There's the little cut without the ball. And you foul. That's a silly play right there by a veteran player. You let him get the deuce. Look at Rick. He's upset. I don't blame him. Look at the intensity. Look at the passion.
Aren't you glad you're not coaching anymore? Can you imagine you over there doing that?
I was so wacky. Are you kidding me? I would have never survived.
Went for the home run pass and turned it over. Another bad decision.
Look at Rick Pitino. He is beside himself. That is really not playing with a good basketball IQ. That is really playing unintelligent basketball with the lead.
That's a play you don't need. Time and score. You're up 7
exactly.
With a minute 10 to go. Get the ball in. Monday Rivalry Week presented by Cisco concludes with a doubleheader right here on ESPN at 7 Eastern. Georgetown will host Villanova, and then at 9 Eastern, Kansas, which got one heck of a battle from Baylor today before subduing the Bears, will take on Texas, the 12th ranked team of the nation, which picked up a win at Iowa State today.
You know, at the time in this game, Georgetown was up 33-23. 33-23. I mean, think about those numbers, how things have changed. You got to play intelligently. You know, they'll say the suit was the difference. I think it was the unbelievable adjustments at halftime and Rick Pitino inspiring his club to come out here with a strong, strong defensive effort.
They have been sensational up until about the last 10 seconds here in the second half. And now the Hoyas have the ball back with a minute 10 to go. How quickly things can change.
They got to make Georgetown take some time. That's this little pressure on you. Take some time off the clock, utilizing some defensive pressure and rotating back in the zone. See, the zone makes you take time off, too.
Under a minute to go. Wallace. Wow, how did that go in as it's down to 5?
These kids don't go away. I'll tell you one thing. You talk about a winner's mentality. No matter what the result is, you can see in the Georgetown kids why they're able to win close games. They just don't absolutely fold over. They never quit.
David Pageant will go to the line. Team foul number 9, so it's still 1-1 for Pageant, who entered the game just a 59% free throw shooter, but tonight is 6 out of 7 from the line. This is a big one right here.
It really comes down to free throw shooting right now. Yeah. I mean, you make your free throws, Louisville gets the W, celebrates, and has a big, big win.
Missed the front end, and the ball is fumbled out of bounds.
They got a lucky break right there, the Cardinals. John Thompson, third, not happy with that play.
John Thompson making subs. Ewing and Rivers come in for defense. Summers and Freeman check out.
Yeah, he's going defense or offense.
And they'll foul Padgett again. This time, though, it'll be two shots.
He's walking quickly to that line like he wants the ball this time. That's Rick. Look at us here. Minus 8, plus 15. That tells me the white suit is going to an auction. And I'm going to get my hands on it and have it auctioned at our event.
Gets the bounce.
I'm going to send my best out to Nick Valvano, who just had aneurysm surgery. Nick, we wish you the best. His brother Bob in town here working at ESPN on Saturday, yep. But works here at Louisville as well.
Nick's one of the, they both are, but speaking of Nick, hoping that he
Nick is
gets
the CEO.
And one, yeah, and one of the great people you'll ever meet.
Wow, he does a terrific job with the V Foundation.
Yeah, all those Valvanos are great guys.
He makes the free throws. That's big. Now you got to play smart defensively. You don't want to foul. You don't want to stop the clock. You want to take some time off or rotate to the zone. Make him take some time off.
Wallace gets a good look. It's not there. Williams the rebound, and he'll walk the floor and shoot free throws.
Louisville wasn't going to be denied here in the second half. This crowd was alive. There was a lot of passion in this house. My friends, there's nothing like having a passion, whatever you do in life. If you do it with passion and feeling. And that's what Louisville did here in the second half. They played with emotion, intensity.
Two free throws for Williams.
Keep them alive. They're just not converting consistently on that line. Hey, think about this, Dan. Tough to win on the road if you're going to score 18 points and a half.
Yep.
And that's what Georgetown has done thus far tonight.
Only gotten to the line 4 times all night long. Did not shoot the three well here tonight at all. 4 out of 21 for the Hoyas from beyond the arc.
They want to get some points quickly. They better send down to Denver and bring Allen Iverson over here. He'll put up a quick 10 in about a minute.
Sack.
Baby is over.
Yep.
It's lights out. It's party time in Louisville. It's celebration time. The Cardinals. It's a big, big W. I mean, he was candid with us before the game. He flat out told us, we're a good team.
Yep.
He said, we are a good team.
They're a team preseason everybody had in their top 10, but Padgett missed 10 games. Palacios missed 9. Character was suspended for 1. Clark was suspended for 1. And they lost some games early. They probably would have won had they been whole. They're whole now, and they're going to be tough for anybody in the country the rest of the way.
Well, you think about their losses. They lost so many tough games early. They lost to BYU by 2, Dayton by 5, Purdue by 8, Cincinnati by 1. They lost to Seton Hall, Connecticut by 2.
Wallace is fouled out. Here's a look at the upcoming schedule for the Cardinals. A couple of road games. A big one a week from Monday here against Syracuse on ESPN. And it doesn't get any easier. At Pitt, taking on Notre Dame here, an Irish team that's 8-2 in the league.
They got 4 W's out of 5. Don't tell Rick I said
wow.
That. He wants all 5.
Wow.
He wants all 5. I'm really impressed the way Williams has bought into the team concept and not worried about the next level. I thought last year he tried to prove to everybody he could make threes.
And he's already said he's coming back next year after some discussion that maybe he was heading out.
I got some recruiting class coming in next year as well. I got a phenomenal kid coming in from out of New Jersey, Samardo Samuels. It's about a St. Benedict's prep. Terrence Jennings played at Notre Dame Prep out in Massachusetts.
All right, let me ask you, because the guys were talking about it, you were up there before the game. Who's the best team in the Big East? There were votes for Connecticut, there were votes for Louisville, there were votes for Georgetown. What do you think?
I think Connecticut, the way they're playing right now, and I see such an upside with to beat, I give them the edge. I think Jim Calhoun has done a masterful job when he disciplined those kids. He sent a message loud and clear that Connecticut basketball is bigger than any kid. I'd give the edge to Connecticut. Notre Dame's got a tough date Wednesday, a little revenge game. Mike Bray's done a great job. And Haron Godey, no doubt, is my choice as player of the year in the conference.
Now, remember, for Connecticut, Wiggins is back. Dyson is still suspended. He'll be out a couple of more weeks. Pittsburgh, Marquette, Syracuse, and Cincinnati rounding out the top half of the league.
I would say tough luck. Pittsburgh and Syracuse with those injuries. It has really been tough for Jamie and for Jim. And they've done a formidable job keeping those clubs so competitive. Yep. I would rate right now the conferences in America. I go Uno number one slightly because I think there's only one team that is not competitive in the conference, Pac-10 one, and I'd go two Big East as the number one and two conferences in the nation.
Louisville ball after the timeout by Georgetown. Now it looks like the Hoyas will have to run out. And the Cardinals spectacular in the second half, a well-deserved win over the number 16 in the country.
Happy birthday.
Thank you.
On Wednesday, I go down
Thank
to Cabin
you. Let's
Indoor
go to
Stadium.
Game.
I go down to see Maryland, the Terps, one of the improved teams. Going to congratulate Gary Williams, got his 600, taking on Duke. But big night, celebration here. Louisville, a brilliant second half.
A big team effort by the Cardinals. David Padgett had 18, Jerry Smith had 16. Terrence Williams, his all-round game. Earl Clark chipped in, the defense was there, and the Cardinals overcome what was a double-digit deficit at a couple of points in the first half to beat Georgetown by eight. Their third win in seven games over Georgetown, first in better than a half century. Here's Aaron with Rick Pitino.
Dan, thanks. Well, Coach, besides the wardrobe change, what was the biggest adjustment your defense made in that second half?
Well, it was just a game of turnovers. We were shooting 60% for most of the half, then went to 50. Gave a few threes. It was just our turnovers in that situation. And my suit was fine. I just spilled Diet Pepsi or Diet Coke all over it at halftime.
Oh, come on!
I went like this and went all over me.
So it wasn't a motivational tool.
No, it really wasn't. I kind of liked it, but it was bringing me bad luck.
Well, seeing exactly how they played in the first half when you wore it, when will we see that white suit again?
Kentucky Derby, first Saturday in May. Outside of that, never wear it again.
All right, we'll take you up on it. Thanks, Coach Dan.
All right, Aaron, great stuff. There it is, right from the horse's mouth, so to speak. Rick Pitino telling us about the wardrobe malfunction he allegedly had at halftime. SportsCenter is coming up next here on ESPN. Louisville defeats Georgetown 59-51. For more on this game, we'll be over on ESPN News in just a moment to wrap things up. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. For Dick Vitale, Aaron Andrews, and our entire ESPN crew, I'm Dan Schulman, thanking you for watching and saying good night from Freedom Hall.